Sometimes the path to a good experiment starts by wording your idea the right way. A testable idea that describes something about the universe is called a hypothesis. Let's say you find a fresh footprint in a forest that you suspect is from a Tasmanian tiger. But Tasmanian tigers are considered extinct. The last known Tasmanian tiger, or thylacine, died in captivity in 1936, but several sightings were recorded after that. So it's possible, just possible, that they're not extinct after all. If we want to work out what's going on, in a scientific way, we first need a proposed explanation for that footprint. We need a hypothesis. A good hypothesis must be worded in a way so it can be tested. More importantly, there should be a way to prove it's wrong or falsified. One way to do this is to propose your hypothesis in a backwards way. It's called a null hypothesis. In this case, it would be saying the Tasmanian tiger is extinct, when you suspect it might not be. Your investigation then proceeds to challenge the null hypothesis with observations and measurement. Studying the footprint is a start, but given how easy it would be to fake, a live specimen might be necessary to convince others to reject the hypothesis. So by this convoluted but very effective way of thinking, science is often not about proving anything, but rather about disproving an old idea in order to build confidence in a new one. Other factors in our experiment can also build confidence. The size of the area we survey will affect how confident we are of the results. A very small sample, say your backyard, might not make us very confident, especially if your backyard is not in Tasmania. But a larger sample, like a national park, would. Another thing that will affect our confidence in the results is variability. If most of Tasmania was like that national park, then we could be more confident that our sample is representative. But it's not. Sample size, the area we choose to survey, and population variability, how different is the terrain, affect how certain we are that our test results will be representative of the big picture. It's not enough to collect observations. To overturn an established idea, you must also convince others that those observations count as evidence.